Hello friends, welcome to this YouTube video program. We are discussing about the use of mixed method research design for conducting educational research. In our earlier program, we have discussed about one of the mixed method research design, that is sequential explanatory design. As I have already said that we can use four type of research design for conducting research in a mixed method approach. So they are sequential explanatory design, then sequential exploratory design, then concurrent triangulation design, then concurrent nested or embedded design. In this program, we'll discuss the second design, that is sequential exploratory design. So let us try to understand the concept of sequential exploratory design and how we can use this design for conducting mixed method research. So before discussing the sequential exploratory design, let me to recapitulate that in our earlier program, when we discuss about sequential explanatory design, I have said that your research will focus upon the quantitative approach, means you will collect data by using the quantitative method or quantitative data you will get, and further your research will follow to get the qualitative data, means in the earlier design, in sequential explanatory design, quantitative method will be the dominant factor. And further, the researcher can take certain qualitative data. But here it is exactly different in the sequential exploratory design. In this design, the researcher collects and analyzes the qualitative data first, followed by the collection and analysis of quantitative data. So what here the researcher will do? First, they will go to collect the qualitative data, means they will design their research in such a way, first they will touch the qualitative aspect of the study, and further the researcher, if they feel that certain quantitative aspect, certain quantitative data, certain quantitative analysis should be done in the research, then they may further proceed to get the quantitative data by using certain tools. But here, as I have already said that in sequential exploratory design, qualitative data is a dominant factor here, because mostly this design is focused upon the qualitative data, you will get the qualitative result. Then data collected from sample through, as example, that you are using, in the survey method, what you are doing, you are using the qualitative data, mostly qualitative in nature. But further, what you are doing, you have selected a sample, and from the other units of the sample, you are using the quantitative approach. Okay. So by using certain tools like you can say questionnaire or test or scale, you are getting certain quantitative data. And what you are doing, you are just comparing qualitative data with quantitative data. So friends, let us take one example and try to understand that how sequential exploratory design can be used in mixed method research. Like in our earlier design, the research title or the example that we had taken, we will discuss taking the same example. So here, let the title is a study on the implementation of workshop-based activities conducted in different program study centers, PSCs, of IGNU BEd program in Delhi region. I repeat the title of your research, that is a study on the implementation of workshop-based activities conducted in different PSCs, Program Study Centers of IGNU BEd program in Delhi region. You see, as I have already told you, BEd is a 2 years program as per the regulation of NCTE, and IGNU follows these 2 years BEd program. 2 years curriculum of the B.Ed. program. You see, there is one compulsory component in B.Ed. program, that is 12 days compulsory workshop based activities, that is one in the first year and other is the second year. And this workshop based activities is conducted in the program study center. So what we will do in this study, this study is focused on the area is of this study is Delhi region. In Delhi, we have three regional centers, RC1, 2 and 3. And your study will confine this area in Delhi region. We have 10 regional centers, 10 study centers under these three regional centers. Okay. Means where the IGNU B.Ed. program is running. So as a researcher, what you will do, you will start your work from a qualitative approach as per this sequential exploratory mixed method research design is concerned. The study started with a qualitative survey of any two IGNU B.Ed. study centers, okay, in Delhi region. Let total study centers is 10. So what you will do, you have done a type of sampling. Randomly, let 10 study centers are there in IGNU Delhi region. So what you have done, let 20% study centers you are taking or 50% study centers you are taking. If 50% study centers you are taking, then out of 10, you have to take randomly, you have to take 5 study centers. Okay. So what you will do, you will start your work starting from the qualitative study. So, by conducting the qualitative study, you will collect the qualitative data by using certain tools like, you can say, interview or focus group discussion or observation of the sessions. You see, what you will do, as a researcher, you will visit the study centers, okay? And when workshop is going on, you have to observe each and every session. You see, we have already given a detailed plan of 12 days, what will be the individual session of every day, okay? So what skill supposed to be developed through this workshop based activities, and what are the other activities, what are the other discussions taking place, and how you know, the learners are engaged in the process of teaching and learning and acquiring certain skills. You will find that most of the sessions are based upon this, okay? Certain practical activities are also there. Okay, they have to write the report, they have to present the report. Certain activities are group-based activities and certain activities are individual activities. So, what the researcher will do, researcher has already an idea that what are the sessions and what are the things supposed to be conducted during the workshop-based activities. Okay, the experts are engaged, you know, to take the sessions, to engage the session. So the researcher will present during the workshop based activities, and the researcher will observe the proceedings of the sessions, each and every sessions, okay, and record it, what is going on in the teaching learning process. So here's here by doing the observation, at the same time the researcher can also take up interview. Okay, interview means interview of the learners, means the learners who are attending the sessions, and the researcher can also take interview of the experts regarding their concern, regarding their, you can say, difficulties, how they are taking the sessions and how they have planned to take the sessions, regarding the resource materials, where they are getting the resources, okay, so what type of you know, inputs they are giving to the learners and what outputs they are getting and what challenges they are facing, okay, what is the strong points, at the same time what are the weaknesses, and they can take the interview of the learners that the quantum of training they are getting, the quality of training they are getting, and what are the things they have learned from this 12 days program, and what are the weak points also, and how these programs can be, or how the sessions can be further developed, further modified, okay, so if there are any limitations. So such type of keeping in consideration of such things, the researcher can take a type of interview. At the same time, researcher can also you know, conduct a focus group discussion, taking group of learners, group of student teachers, they can establish a type of discussion, okay. So here by observing the things, by taking the interview of the learners as well as the experts, okay, and by doing the focus group discussion, the intention of the researcher will get the qualitative data, okay, qualitative data about the implementation of workshop based activities. But during the research, if the researcher feels that he or she is touching only the qualitative aspect, but at the same time, for knowing the achievement level of the student teachers, the BA learners, they should go for a type of quantitative data. Okay, so for the quantitative data, what the researcher can do, as they have already taken 50% as the sample size, means out of 10 program study centers, they have taken 50%, means 5 program study centers. So they will develop certain other tools, they will use certain other tools to gather quantitative data. Okay. So other tools that they can use, like they can use a type of questionnaire, okay, and they can also use a type of achievement test, means after completion of 12 days program, they can prepare a test basing upon each and every session, basing upon the training components, basing upon the skills that they have acquired, okay, and basing upon the practical activities that they have done. So basing upon the pedagogy, methodology, teaching learning process, skills, okay, means the detailed curriculum component of 12 days workshop, they can prepare a test and they can administer that test upon the group of learners who are attending the session, attending the workshop. So here they are getting a quantitative data, means they are getting certain score. Okay, so qualitative data already they have received, then again here they are getting certain quantitative data by using your questionnaire or test or scale. If the researcher wants to know about the attitude of the student teachers, of the learners about this 12 days workshop based activities, compulsory activities, and at the same time the experts who are engaged to take the sessions, if the researcher wants to know their attitude also, they can use a type of rating scale, a type of attitude scale. So by using the attitude scale, by using the test, by using the questionnaire, mostly quantitative data the researcher will get. So already they have started this study as per this design that they have received already the qualitative data, and further realizing that there is the essence, there is the need of certain quantitative data for better analysis, at the same time to better for better understanding about the phenomena, about the implementation of workshop based activities, about the output of the activities, the researcher further followed the quantitative aspect to collect the quantitative data. So here in this by conducting such technique, such procedure, the researcher will get both qualitative data as well as quantitative data. Then after getting qualitative data and quantitative data, they can compare it, they can contrast it, okay, they can correlate it, and they can better understand the phenomena, they can better understand the real implementation of the workshop based activities in the study centers. So friends, by using either sequential explanatory design that we had discussed in our earlier program, and by using sequential exploratory design, here you see both type of methods the researcher is using. Okay, in earlier quantitative method was used first and followed by a qualitative method, and in this design, in exploratory, sequential exploratory design, here qualitative method is used first followed by a quantitative method. So here both the, means in mixed method research, both quantitative and qualitative data gathering techniques are used for better understanding the phenomena, for better understanding the research, and to study it in its depth. So that's why the mixed method approach is very much important. But at the same time, I would like to say that it depends upon the nature of the problem, that what type of data you require, accordingly you have to plan your study. So friends, in this program today we discuss about the sequential exploratory design. In our next program we will discuss other mixed method design that can also be used for conducting research. Thank you.